It's AumSum time! How can some people predict rain?
By asking Thor, the thunder god.
Now, there are two ways by which rain can be predicted. First case occurs just before the beginning of heavy rainfall. Here, lightning bolts split nitrogen and oxygen molecules, eventually producing ozone. Now, strong blowing winds carry ozone downward along with them. Ozone is a sharp smelling gas. When a person smells this ozone, it helps him predict the rain. Now, the second case occurs when it is already raining somewhere nearby. Usually, surfaces of soil and leaves have aromatic particles of dust and oil on them. When raindrops hit these surfaces, tiny air bubbles containing these aromatic particles are created. Just like fizz rushes upwards in a soda bottle, these air bubbles rush upwards and burst out. Then, gusts of wind carry them ahead of the rain, helping us smell the aromatic particles and predict rain. Blood rain! Relax! Blood rain has red-colored water droplets. There are various reasons behind this. Around Sahara Desert, brownish dust and sand carried by storms mix with water droplets and clouds, giving rain its brownish-red color. In Kerala, red spores of algae called Trentifolia annulata got carried by wind and mixed with water droplets, causing blood rain. While in Zamora, Haematococcus pluvialis algae got caught in rain clouds, got stressed, and produced a red pigment called astaxanthin, causing blood rain. Why does water dance on a hot pan? Cause it likes to sizzle. And 100 degrees Celsius. Get ready, water droplets. It's time to boil and evaporate. Okay, let's cross 200 degrees, guys. Whoa, it's so hot that the lower part of the water droplet immediately vaporizes. Holy moly, what's that? An insulating vapor pocket is created beneath the droplet. And now, the vapor molecules are trying to escape from it. They are pushing the droplet around, making it dance. This is called the Leidenfrost effect. Why does water go stale overnight?
Cause you left it alone overnight.
Nah. In water purification plants, chlorine is added to water. Chlorine kills microorganisms in water, thus keeping it clean and safe to drink. This chlorine gives our drinking water a slightly different taste. However, if we keep the water open for a long time or overnight, the chlorine will dissipate into air. As a result, the taste of water alters. Also, water is a universal solvent. It can dissolve almost anything. Hence, if we keep water open for quite a long time, the atmospheric carbon dioxide gets dissolved in it. This results in the formation of mild carbonic acid.
What? Acid is formed in water?
Indeed. However, it is not harmful. But the presence of carbonic acid slightly lowers the pH of water, making it slightly acidic and thus unpleasant to taste.